Hi everyone, and welcome to another video on Windows 11. Microsoft released their 2024 update for Windows 11, better known as 24H2, just a few days ago. And as you probably know if you're watching this video, Windows 11 comes with some specific hardware requirements. In this video, I will show you how you can perform a clean installation of Windows 11 24H2 on unsupported hardware. Windows 11 theoretically requires your machine to support secure boot, have a TPM 2.0 module, and your CPU to be on the list of compatible models. By working around these hardware checks, it has been possible to run Windows 11 without any issues for quite some time now. Performance is pretty good and similar to Windows 10, updates are working fine, and all in all, everything works just as you would expect. What does require some action is that with each major update, as it was the case last year for 23H2, the year before for 22H2, and now as well with the latest version, 24H2, the method you can use to skip these hardware checks during installation or while upgrading do change a bit. For each of these in the past, I've been documenting a new workaround, and this video is no difference to that. As there are multiple possible scenarios to get Windows 11 24H2 on your unsupported machine, depending on your starting point, I decided to publish three separate videos covering each of these. This video covers performing a fresh installation of Windows 11 24H2 on your unsupported hardware if you want to start clean or need to install the OS from scratch. If you are already on an earlier version of Windows 11, like 23H2, 22H2, or even older, you can use the video for which I'll put a card here now instead. And if you're looking how to upgrade Windows 11 starting from Windows 10 on unsupported hardware, you can use the one that appears here now. For this video, I'll be using my Dell Optiplex 9020, which I also used in the past to test and play around with Windows 11 extensively. This machine is about 9 years old now and is equipped with a 4th generation Intel Core i5 CPU, does not have secure boot enabled, and does not support the TPM 2.0 requirement. In other words, without any workarounds, we would not be able to install Windows 11 on here. To do a clean installation, you will also need a USB drive of at least 8 GB, and as a first step in the process, we'll prepare that one to make it a bootable Windows 11 installer. You can prepare this USB drive on any other Windows machine. It doesn't have to be the one where you will install Windows, and that machine also doesn't need to be yet on Windows 11. One thing that I do need to mention here that is really different from 23H2 is that since this new version, 24H2, Microsoft started to rely on a specific SSE 4.2 CPU instruction called POPCNT. In other words, this is a real hardware limitation, so CPUs that do not have this instruction built in will not be able to run 24H2. And the bad news is that if you would have such a CPU, your system will no longer boot anymore after upgrading. The good news is that your CPU needs to be over 15 years old for this to be the case. For Intel CPUs, for example, anything that's an Intel Core CPU or newer, which was introduced already back in 2008, or for AMD about everything that got released after the same year, does have support for that instruction. So unless you have a really old CPU, you should be fine. Let's go ahead now and start by first doing a quick cleanup of the USB drive. Although this step is completely optional, it could prevent some problems with leftover settings or weird partitions on that drive. To do so, after inserting the drive, let's start disk part by pressing the start key, type disk part, and then press enter. In disk part, type the command list disk. In here, we need to find our USB drive. By using the size column, it should be relatively easy to identify which one that is. Then we need to type select disk and the number that matches the USB drive in the list. In my case, the USB drive is disk 1. Now we can clean up everything simply by typing the clean command followed by pressing enter. Alright, everything has been completely removed from that USB drive now, so we need to reinitialize the drive before we can use it to create installation media. Let's start disk management to do so. So press start, type diskmgmt.msc and press enter. In disk management, we see our same disk 1 here, which is our USB drive. And we can see as well that it's completely clean. Right click on it and choose new simple volume. Click next, leave it to use all space. Click next again, let the wizard assign a drive letter and click next once more. Give the drive a volume label which you can recognize, and then finish the rest of the wizard. After a bit of patience, This should create a volume and format it as we instructed. Okay, that was a bit of extra work, but at least we now have a well-prepared USB drive and we are ready to get it to turn into a Windows 11 24H2 installation drive. To do so, let's open our browser and navigate to the Download Windows 11 website. As you can see, there are several options available here, but the easiest way to create a bootable USB drive is to use the Media Creation tool. Once the tool is downloaded, let's go to our Downloads folder and start it from here. In this screen, you can choose a different language if you like. Then click Next and choose for a USB flash drive. Click Next again and select the drive with the volume label that represents your USB drive. And then we need to click Next once more and wait patiently for the required files to be downloaded and copied over to the drive. This can definitely take some time, mainly depending on your download speed and the write speed of that drive. There we are. Our USB drive is now fully prepared and can now be used to boot from and perform a clean installation. As mentioned, this can be used or reused for different machines as well, supported and unsupported, and definitely not only on the machine where you created this drive. Now to continue, I will do a clean installation on that Optiplex 9020 as well. So let us insert the USB drive and then let the system boot from it. I will do that by bringing up the boot menu, which on this Dell machine can be done by pressing F12 multiple times immediately after powering up the PC. Here we have it. For other brands and models, the key to use for this might be different. Next to F12, Escape or F10 are pretty common as well. And as you can see in the boot menu, we get another confirmation that Secure Boot is off, so in theory, it shouldn't be possible to install Windows 11 on here. Another thing which I recommend, at least if you don't want to be forced to use a Microsoft account to log into your machine, is to disconnect it from the internet before proceeding. This is not a requirement to bypass the unsupported hardware though. The USB drive is selected as a device to boot from. So let's press Enter to launch the Windows 11 installer from there. After a bit of patience again, we get to see the new user interface of the installer. I'm really not sure if I find this an improvement, but it is what it is. Click Next here after selecting your language, time and currency format. In the next screen, select the correct keyboard layout and then click Next again. Now, before we continue here, we will need to add a few registry keys to work around the hardware requirements. If you would not do this, you'll most likely end up at this screen, and if that would be the case for you, you will need to restart the installer from the USB drive and make sure to follow the next steps correctly. Obviously, we want to prevent this, and that can be done by pressing Shift F10 while being at this screen. This should bring up a command prompt. In the command prompt, start the registry editor by typing regedit and then press Enter. In the registry editor, navigate to H key local machine, system, setup. Then on the setup folder, right click and choose new key and give it the name labconfig. In the labconfig key, right click and choose new dword 32-bit. Give the dword the name bypass TPM check. Pay attention that it's exactly as in the video. Repeat the process and choose again new dword 32-bit, and this time give it the name bypass secure boot check. Again, make sure that the name matches exactly as I have in the video. Then double click on each of the variables and set the value to 1 in order to enable them. This is how it should look like. If you got this right, we can close the registry editor and exit from the command prompt. Back at the Select Setup option screen, select I agree everything will be deleted including files, apps and settings, then click Next. Enter your product key if it wasn't automatically detected or click I don't have a product key. Then select the version to install. As this machine has been properly activated with Windows Home before, I will choose for that edition here. And just for clarity, this method will work equally fine if you want to install Windows 11 Home or Professional, depending on which activation key you have available, of course. In this screen now, we need to select where to install Windows 11. Again, this looks completely different and a bit more modern from the old version which we had up to 23H2. Here, I will simply select all partitions which are still there one by one and delete them. This new interface turned out to be a bit laggy, and hopefully Microsoft will still correct this, as it feels like you can really easily select and delete the wrong partition, and you really don't want that. Eventually, when everything is gone, we can select all the unallocated space and then click Next. And finally, on the Ready to Install screen, we can click Install. There we go. At this point, Windows 11 24H2 is being installed on the drive you selected, and you will again need to be a bit patient. If all goes well, you should eventually end up at this initial setup dialog, asking you to select your country or region. If you have your PC connected to the internet, and you are okay to use a Microsoft account, you can just continue here. If, on the other hand, you prefer to use a local account instead, or have a machine which is not connected to the internet, we will go through an extra step. Otherwise, you cannot continue without internet or that account. To do so, open a command prompt in the same way as we did before, so by pressing Shift F10 on the keyboard. Then in the command prompt, type OOBE /bypass NRO, all in one word, and then press Enter. This will trigger a quick reboot and bring up the same wizard, but as you will see in the next steps, we will be able to skip that requirement to be connected to the internet. Let's start by selecting the country and keyboard layout, and then we get to the screen where we connect to a network or, thanks to that command which you entered earlier, can skip that requirement. Next, we need to enter our username or log in to a Microsoft account if you're connected and choose some of the privacy settings. And after another bit of waiting, we finally end up at our fresh Windows 11 24H2 desktop on unsupported hardware. Looks like the installation is a success, so let me reconnect the machine now to the internet and let's take a look at System About. Here we can see that I'm still on that unsupported hardware, and indeed we have Windows 11 Home 24H2 successfully on here. Let's have a look at the activation status as well. Looks like this went fine, and the fact that we bypassed the hardware check didn't influence this at all. And to double check, let's see if we can find some of the changes that were introduced in this new version. The quick settings, for example, now has pages. Something new in File Explorer is when you're trying to compress some files, we can now choose multiple formats. We also seem to have the new Phone Link application available and working. And even Windows Copilot seems to be here and fully functional. Those are just a few small examples of the changes, but more importantly, as you could see, we managed to install the latest and greatest version of Windows 11 on this unsupported hardware. One last small thing, which I saw coming by a few times in the previous videos, is related to Windows updates. As with all of the previous versions of Windows 11 and different workarounds on unsupported hardware, this is just working exactly as it would be on supported hardware. As you can see, updates are being found and installed just fine on here. That was all for the video. I hope this will help you to extend the life of your machine. If you have liked this video, I would appreciate a thumbs up. Let me know how this worked for you or if you have any questions in the comments. And make sure to subscribe if you like these kind of videos. Thanks again and hope to see you back here soon.